Okay, so for the mold detox, first thing you're supposed to get out of mold. Make sure you're out of mold. Sometimes there's mold that's hidden in your house and you can't find it. Some people are still able to heal when there's mold in their home. And I'm a negative person since I'm trying, I'm working on it. But I'm like, oh, there's probably mold in our bathroom, like behind the tiles. We had a mold guy come in and he said there probably wasn't anything. But I am getting better from when I was. All of this started. I am sleeping now. My anxiety is not so bad. I am doing brain retraining, which I'm sure a lot of you have heard about. I always thought it sounded silly to me, but it's actually working. So don't ditch it if you haven't tried it. So try it. I am doing foot baths or a Epsom salt bath. I'm doing a cup of Epsom salts, and I also put in a tablespoon for potassium because your electrolytes can get all wonky when you do Epsom salt baths. I have almost passed out after doing because all the magnesium is a vasodilator, so you have to be careful there. But I do cream of tartar, which is potassium, a tablespoon in my foot baths, a little more in a big bath, but I prefer foot baths since I had to buy my bath. It's one on Amazon because we only have a shower. So, doing that, if you can tolerate a sauna, which I can't because of the heat intolerance, that's a really big help because you're able to sweat out the toxins. But you have to make sure you take a shower after you sweat that out because it'll just be reabsorbed. So that's a key point there. Also, if you can tolerate NAC or glutathione, don't take both because NAC is the precursor to glutathione. So if you can handle glutathione, take that. It's not for long term though. But if you can't try NAC, I was doing 600 milligrams. This one is by Nutricost, but I can't take it now because of the sulfur issue that I'm having, which I don't know why. Still working on that. Digestive enzymes. I was taking one with each meal. Now I'm taking two with each meal because I need all the help I can get with digestion. And now I'm suffering from constipation, which I never had an issue with, but Klebsiella can do that. It's a SIBO issue as well. Now this is high salicylate biocidin. It's got a ton of different herbs in there, but for some reason it doesn't give me a salicylate issue. I think the way they extract the herb has something to do with it. I don't really understand it. Also, I have sinus issues, so I'm taking X-Clear. It's a stevia-based nasal spray. I'm doing two pumps like three times a day. That helps break up biofilms if you have Marcons, which that can also be with mold. And then also Argentin 23, which is a colloidal silver spray, that will break down the bacteria. And that takes a few months to fix. I'm getting a little better with the nose issue. I still don't understand why I would have fungal nose issues if I'm not in mold. That's a mystery. Okay, next video.